10 types of roommates. Number 1, the one who steals your stuff.
La 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 la. I wonder where my sister is. Ooh, but look at that big old lollipop. I don't think she'll mind if I take it. Yes, sweet lollipop. Ooh, that was delicious. Hey sis, have you seen the lollipop that was on my bed?
Oh, yeah, I have.
Okay, where'd it go?
In my tummy?
Oh, my bird. Do you know that's stealing? Last week you stole my My Little Pony notebook, and then you stole my cupcake, and you also stole my croissant, and now my lollipop? You're such a thief.
Number 2, the one who uses your stuff.
Oh, what's her password? Sis! Sis! Come here for a second. What do you want? What's the password to your laptop? And who said you could use my laptop? Did you ask for my permission? Just because we share the same room doesn't mean my stuff is yours, okay? It's my stuff. Yada, yada, yada. So what's the password? I'm not telling you. It's my laptop for a reason. Go outside and use the computer.
Oh, don't be like that. Just tell me what the password is. I need to use it real quick.
Or here, why don't you type in the password and that will solve it. No. Do you know what's called privacy? Go outside and use the computer. Don't use my stuff.
Fine, if you're gonna be that way, but last time I checked, the password was King Kong 123. I'ma try that. King Kong 123. Enter.
Ooh, yeah. Guess you didn't change your password.
Ugh. Well, it's gonna change after this.
Number 3, be inconsiderate or rude.
Yeah, and so when I saw her, I was like, she needs to stop because she is so rude. And if she doesn't want to work on the project, I mean, that's not my issue. It's not like I wanted her to be in my project team. Yeah, seriously, if she doesn't do her work, I'm going to have to report her to the teacher. That's what I'm saying. Gets me angry talking about her. I know, right? Okay, yeah, I'll talk to you later. Okay, peace out. Got me all angry.
What's up?
Did you not see me sleeping?
No, I saw you. Why?
Then why can't you be a little more considerate and be, like, quiet? You woke me up from my nap.
You shouldn't be napping right now anyway. It's not bedtime yet.
Come on. Next time, can you be a little more considerate and be, like, quiet?
Let me think. No, because this is my room too.
Number 4, the bossy.
I'm hungry. Are you gonna go get some food?
Nah, I'm not hungry yet.
Oh, okay. Since I'm hungry, why don't you go to the kitchen and grab me the leftovers from yesterday?
Why can't you go?
Cause I'm working on something.
So am I.
Okay, fine, don't go. Go get me some water instead.
Why?
Cause I'm thirsty.
Why can't you go?
I told you, I'm busy.
Why do you always gonna boss me around?
Cause you're younger than me.
Number 5, the cleaner.
Hey, do you mind leaving the room for like 30 minutes so I can clean?
Wait, didn't you just clean like last week?
Yeah, sorry, I have like a phobia. I'm like afraid of dirt and stuff, so I like to clean a lot. I'm a clean person, you know?
Okay, that's fine. I'll be back in 30 minutes then.
Time to get to work. So first I gotta clean the floor and then I gotta air dry it because it's gonna be wet.
All that dust is nasty.
Okay, now the floor is wet, so I gotta air dry it.
Wait, I missed a spot here. It's still dirty.
Number 6, the dirty.
Why do you have all that stuff? You have like desserts on your bed and desserts on the floor. That's kind of, you know, ants could come. Oh, sorry, I was eating on my bed, and you know, the ones that I don't want to eat yet, I just threw on the ground for now. I'm sure the ants won't come, don't worry about it.
Yeah, but still, it's kind of dirty, you know? I'll clean it up later.
Wait, but that pink cake on the ground, hasn't it been there for like a week? Can you still eat it?
I think it still tastes good.
Ew, is that like mold?
I'll just bite off the mold and the rest of the cake is just as new.
Oh, okay. Enjoy your, meal.
Ugh.
Number 7. The ones who don't get along.
So what? I'm gonna tell mom on you.
Tell mom then. You know who's right and who's wrong. Obviously you're wrong.
Nuh-uh.
Uh-huh.
Nuh-uh.
Uh-huh.
I said no.
I said no.
Ugh. Mom!
Mom!
You need to stop copying me.
You need to stop copying me.
You need to stop because you are so ridiculous. I cannot believe you just copied me. I'm going to tell mom and she's going to ground you. I cannot handle you being my roommate. I need a new room. I need to move out.
Number 8. Be embarrassed.
Wait, I don't get it. What do you mean you go outside your room?
Well, you know, I share a room with my sister.
Uh-huh.
And I'm just embarrassed to fart in the room because I don't know, it smells.
So you go outside to fart and then go back in the room?
Well, yeah, I mean, I walk outside the room to fart and then I like air it out because I don't want other people to smell it either. And then I just go back in the room.
Does she fart in the room?
Oh yeah, all the time.
Then what's the big deal? It's human nature to fart, so you should just fart in the room too.
Ugh, I'm just embarrassed. I just can't.
Number 9, the hermit.
Where's your sister?
She's in the room like always.
Oh, what do you mean like always? Like she never leaves the room. She's in the room 24/7. The only time she leaves the room is when she takes a dump, like uses the restroom. She even brings her food to the room to eat. Like she's always in there. So the only time she's out is when she's in the bathroom, which is when she's taking a dump or taking a shower. But other than that, she's always in the bedroom.
Oh, do you share a room with her?
Yep, and she's always in there, always.
Number 10, the farter.
Sorry, sis, I ate too many beans tonight.
Oh, it's...
okay.